This screencast will show how to develop mathematical models which involve more than one differential equation. The problem that we're going to analyze is shown on the screen, and what shows we have a blending tank which mixes two streams with different mass flow rates with different concentrations of salt. The tank is well mixed, as an assumption, and the outlet has a mass flow rate of W and a salt concentration of X. And the question is asking us to develop a dynamic model that accounts for how height changes as a function of time and how salt concentration changes as a function of time. In order to do this, what we have to do is start with our mass balances, because there's no indication that there is a change in temperature, which would mirror an energy balance. So let's start with the mass balance. The general mass balance equation has been presented here, where accumulation equals in minus out plus generation minus reaction. In this case, no chemical reactions occurring, so therefore the last two terms will go to zero. The important point to note with this problem is the fact that we're trying to track two different values as a function of time, both salt concentration and tank height. Due to the fact that we're trying to track two variables, provides a good hint that we're probably going to need two differential equations. So the question now becomes is, what differential equations can we develop here? First is, we can develop an overall balance, which would include the salt and the water. And our second balance would be component balance, either salt or water. In this case, since we're trying to track salt concentration and everything's been defined as such, it probably makes best sense to stick with a salt balance. So first, we will start by developing our mathematical model by starting with an overall balance. In our overall balance, we have two streams coming in, both W1 and W2, and we have one stream coming out, which is W. For our accumulation term, is going to be d mass, d time. And our mass here will be over the control volume over which we are completing our mass balance, which in this case is our tank. So if we quickly draw the sketch of the tank here, the amount of mass in the tank at any given time, remember the fact that we had a height h and a cross-sectional area a, the amount of mass can be simply written as the density of the fluid multiplied by the volume of the fluid. The volume can be further simplified by multiplying the cross-sectional area A multiplied by the height H. And the right-hand side is remaining unchanged. For a final simplification, what we can do here is factor out the rho and the A because they are both assumed constant. So that will leave us with our overall mass balance. And as you note here, that H is in the differential, which will allow for it to be tracked as a function of time. So therefore, we have our first part of our mathematical model. For the salt balance, just as a recollection to the problem statement, the amount of salt was provided in terms of mass fractions. So what we're now trying to do here is develop a balance for the amount of salt we have. For the first stream, W1, W1 represents the total mass of fluid coming in. The salt mass fraction says what fraction of that mass flow rate is salt. So therefore, in order to get the mass of salt, all we have to do is multiply this flow rate by the salt mass fraction. We do the same thing for both the second inlet stream and the outlet stream. And our accumulation term will represent the amount of salt that is in the tank. And this analysis is very similar to what we just completed with the overall mass balance accumulation term, with the only difference being the fact that we have to multiply by the mass fraction of salt inside the tank. Since our tank is well mixed, we can say the fact that the outlet mass fraction of salt is going to equal the mass fraction of salt inside the tank. So what that leaves us with in the accumulation term is rho times the volume, which can be represented as A times H, multiplied by the mass fraction of salt, which is X. So before we look at the right-hand side of this equation, what we're going to do is factor out the left-hand side. However, if we look at this, we notice that we have a bit of an issue. The fact that both H and X here are variables. We really can't handle a derivative which has h and x in it in order to do any useful analysis. So therefore, when we see situations like this, what we have to do is we have to use the chain rule as applied to derivatives. In order to use the chain rule here, this term is now going to become two terms, one where the first variable inside the derivative is held constant, and one where the second term inside the derivative is held constant. So therefore, our left-hand side now becomes, we'll hold h constant first, so rho ah dx dt plus rho ax multiplied by dh dt. At first glance, this looks like it could potentially be quite a problem, trying to solve an equation with two differentials in it. But fortunately, we already have a relationship for rho a dh dt. So the relationship for rho a dh dt, well, we already solved for that. That came from our overall mass balance. So therefore, what we can now do is substitute the right-hand side into our equation. Now what we'll do is substitute in this equation and also bring back our right-hand side of the equation for our salt balance. And what this gives us is rho ah dx dt. We can't really do too much with that, and that's fine because really our goal here is to be able to develop an equation that tracks the salt concentration inside the tank as a function of time, and that is what this does. We'll then add x multiplied by the right-hand side of our overall mass balance, and it's going to equal our right-hand side of our salt balance. What we'll now do is move the second term on the left-hand side over to the right in order to isolate the derivative. By looking at our terms on the right-hand side, the first thing that jumps out is that the xw terms can cancel. The second thing we can do here is group together our w1 terms and our w2 terms. So once we complete this, we've reached our final mathematical model. We have rho ah dx dt equals w1 multiplied by x1 minus x plus w2 times x2 minus x. So therefore, the mathematical model that describes the salt mass fraction inside the tank and the height as a function of time can be expressed by both this equation and the mass balance that we developed for the overall mass balance. So these two equations together provide the dynamic model for the system.